Welcome to Jay Cotto's Fight Page. And today I'll be bringing you boxing news. And this is consisting of boxing as to, let's say, 2 weeks behind or 2 weeks ago, all the way going through November or this upcoming October and November. And I'm giving you what's been out there so far. And I'm just trying to detangle angles for you guys because there's a lot of bullshit going on. Now, let's start off with Lomachenko versus Nick Walters, all right? That fight has been made. It's for November 26th. Bob Arum says Walters got a bit more than the previous offer he was offered. So, obviously, they made this fight. I would like to say thank you, Bob Arum, for making this fight and continue to keep showing all these fucking wannabe promoters exactly how you make fights and how you don't stall or marinate or et cetera, et cetera. Now, Bob Arum also says that the offer De La Hoya offered Golovkin is bullshit, okay? He spoke on Ramirez Golovkin for next year. He says that, he has to do a percentage deal, never a flat rate. Also, that he should get a bigger percentage. Now, it's nowhere near MAPAC, but it could do well, you know? And this is exactly what I was saying. Now, these counter offers that De La Hoya is doing is basically what Floyd Mayweather Jr. did to Manny Pacquiao and to other fighters, not pricing themselves out, but basically just trying to make flat fee fights, you know what I mean? And you know, their fighters taking the percentage of the pay-per-view model. Now, this is exactly why the pay-per-view model will not die. It will never die. The television model is going to die. Of course it's going to die. From what I hear, PBC is in $400 million debt with its investors, and, you know, you guys can't fucking hate me or hate anyone that's reporting this because this is what's coming to fruition. So you can thank Al Heyman all you like, but it's just the fact of the matter is that the man is not built for this sport. No man can capitalize on boxing. You guys have to understand that. You know what I mean? You have to understand that. No man can capitalize in the sport of boxing. If Arum, Duva, Dabila, De La Hoya, King, if they weren't able to do it, what makes you think a music promoter is going to do it? You understand what I'm saying, guys? You guys have to understand that there are lanes that people should be in and staying in, and they're not. And it's okay to do business ventures, but it's not okay to fucking fool the fans and take the fans' money. Now, Nonito Donaire faced off against his opponent, Jesse Magdaleno. And, well, let's see what Donaire has left. Because to tell you the truth, I mean, his last fight was pretty impressive. It was okay. But the vet is getting old. And he's, like, been there forever. And I'm still waiting for the rematch against him and, Walters, if that ever comes to fruition. But if it doesn't, it is what it is. Good luck to Nonito Donaire. It's good to see you back in the ring. Brandon Rios is making a comeback on December 3rd. And, he's going to be on the Chavez Jr. card. And I just have to say, man, you know, I've said this before. I'll say it again. I am very worried about Brandon Rios' health within that ring. He already shows, some, you know, slurring signs as well as, late reaction time. And I think it's time to hang him up, brother. I know you don't want to let go because, but your style, your fighting style has allowed you to be, you know what I'm saying, susceptible to actually catching concussive shots the way you have within your career, and this is what happens. Now, I do want to wish him luck, and I really do hope that if when he makes a comeback, he can actually put a stamp on his name and at least get one more title shot. After that, my brother, I think you should just hang him up, become a trainer, do what Fernando Vargas did. Now, Anthony Joshua may have a bit of a surprise for us, as Klitschko or Parker, okay, are names that are being put out there. Now, some say Joshua may not be ready for Klitschko, but Joshua has proven otherwise. Parker is the new young threat and has fight fans buzzing, you know. This new prospect is making an impact, and perhaps a Joshua Parker fight is a bit more possible. But at the same time, we've got King Kong Ortiz calling Anthony Joshua. Now, ever since Deontay Wilder has been out for his injuries, his bicep and his hand injury, Anthony Joshua is the next man on everybody's list. And I say, let's get it. Now, this is sad, guys. Just want to tell you, before Tyson Fury pulled out of the fight, right? And it wasn't discussed as to why. So now it comes to fruition that he actually failed the VADA testing and is being stripped. Okay, he is being stripped of all his titles. Now, I don't know what's going to go on. Maybe this looks like Joshua Klitschko for the vacant straps. We don't know. Let's see what's going to happen, because to tell you the truth, this is some crazy shit. Tyson Fury will no longer have my respect. Everybody in England, if you still respect them, then I just don't know where your logic and, you know, for the sport is, where the respect for the sport is. Because as big as he is, you know, on PEDs, he can most definitely kill somebody in there. You know what I mean? And I'm sorry, but Tyson Fury no longer has my respect. You know, no longer has my respect. And I guess the guilt was eating him to the point that he just couldn't do it. But, like Beanie Siegel said, whatever doesn't come out in the washer will definitely come out in the ringer. Now, back to King Kong Ortiz. King Kong Ortiz has called out Anthony Joshua mid last week, and perhaps he may be the new opponent for Joshua at the O2 Arena. But the heavyweight division isn't fucking around. We also have the Beast Briggs looking for new beef, Baby Miller wanting Wilder, Stiverne Povetkin's coming, and Briggs just got called out by a big fucking heavyweight. And it's getting crazy, fight fans, so just stay tuned, you know, stay tuned, man. Now, the welterweight division still awaits a title defense from WBC champion Danny Garcia. It is said that he will fight Johnny Molina Jr. Now, as some feel, Molina may pull the upset. Now, some, not most, some. Giving Broner a hard time, Garcia is a much harder hitter than Broner and can box. But has he diminished? Is his power there at 147, guys? Can he handle a Porter, Thurman, Khan, or even a Berto? Or any legit 147-pounder? This is why he needs to get busy, because Thurman, Porter, Spence Jr., and every other fighter in 147 are putting in that work for their careers. They're making legacies. They have to push Garcia harder. And when I say they, it's his father. Danny Garcia has great potential. I get on him simply because I want him to start driving his own fucking career. Now, Golovkin Jacobs is coming up as well. And this fight is one we fight fans can expect. Okay? We can expect a good, entertaining fight. Jacobs may not win for most, but to some, like myself, I think he has the tools. The chin factor is not that serious. One loss does not make him a chandelier jaw or a chandelier chin-having motherfucker. This will be a great, okay, a great name and quality fight for both men. Okay? Now, reason why I say I hope Jacobs wins is simply because if Gennady Golovkin and Canelo Alvarez are not going to fight, then fuck it, dead it. I just wish somebody would put a fucking shovel in it or a monkey wrench and that's it. Because once one of the men lose, that fight is no longer viable. No longer in our minds, and we can just move the fuck on. You know what I'm saying? We can just move the fuck on. This is just wasting our time. It's making everybody, you know, a racist and basically exposing a lot of fucking casuals. The division in boxing, okay, omitting the heavyweight division, needs to step it up in 2017. The lightweight division is getting heated up, okay? We've got Postal, Crawford, Easter Jr., Roman Gonzalez is holding his division down as well, along with other talents like Quadras. As the middleweight division is in a stump, the junior middleweight division is cooking because of Canelo, but at the same time holding up the middleweight division because of not wanting to fight unified champion, undisputed champion, Gennady Golovkin. The light heavyweight division is really pulling up to speed as we await Ward Kovalev in November. This is what graduates fighters and gives the fight fans the love they deserve in return from the sport. Maybe they have decided to give us the floor because only we, the fight fans, know what's good for business while knowing what's good for the sport. My name is Jay Cotto. Thank you for joining my fight page. God bless. Stay vigilant. Peace.